2.6b, order of operations with fractions. There's an order of operations. The first step is P. The second step is E. The third step is M/D. And the fourth step is A/S. An easy way to remember this is with PEMDAS, or Please Excuse My Dear Aunt Sally. P stands for parentheses. And this includes absolute values. Then there's E for exponents. M/D is for multiply and divide. As you can see, these are all in one step. This is because you do multiply and divide as they appear from left to right. A and S is for add and subtract. And this you also do from left to right as they appear, which means sometimes you may be doing multiplying before divide or divide before multiply. The same with adding and subtracting. For order of operations with fractions, you may need some scratch paper. Or you just use the side of your paper. Let's look at how this works in example one. Here is example one. We start off by thinking about our order of operations, meaning we start with P. P is for parentheses. As you can see, there are parentheses here, but there is nothing to do inside of the parentheses. And remember, the parentheses step is only for things that are inside the parentheses. Therefore, there is none. And we can skip the P step. We then move on to E for exponents. As you can see, there is an exponent. So we do this step off to the side, which is 5/2 × 5/2, which means we get 25/4. So we place this back into the problem. And we carry down everything else from above. Now we can move on to the multiply divide step. Remember, it's multiply and divide from left to right, not multiply first, then divide second. This means we must do the division first. Remember, we do not know how to divide fractions, we simply multiply them. This means that our 9/10 divided by 12/5 actually turns into 9/10 × 5/12. Remembering that you flip over the second fraction or you multiply it by its reciprocal. Also remember, we should always reduce before multiplying fractions. 5 goes into 5 once and goes into 10 twice. 3 goes into 9 3 times and 3 goes into 12 4 times. This is now reduced and we have 3 times 1 is 3 and 2 times 4 is 8, which gives us 3/8. We place this in the problem and then carry down everything else. As you can see, there is still a multiply. This means we are not done with the multiply and divide step. We must continue on. We now multiply 25/4 × 1/30. Remember, we must reduce before multiplying. 5 goes into 25 5 times, and 5 goes into 30 6 times. We now have 5/24. And we place this back in the problem. We have now simplified it down to 3/8 + 5/24. And we also are ready for the add and subtract step. Remember, when adding and subtracting fractions, we must have a common denominator. The least common denominator of these two numbers is 24. So we must change each of them to make them match. So 3/8 will need to be multiplied by 3 on both the numerator and the denominator. And the 5/24 does not need to change. This now gives us 9/24 plus 5/24. When we add these together, 9 plus 5 is 14 over 24. Remember, whenever you have a fraction as an answer, you must reduce that answer. Both of these numbers divide by 2, which means that we get 7 over 12, or 7/12, which is our final answer. Let's see how this works in example 2. Here's example 2. Once again, we start with doing the order of operations, starting with P for parentheses. Remember, an absolute value counts as a parenthesis, which means that this absolute value is actually acting as a parenthesis. So we must do what is inside first, which means we have 7/3 minus 9/2. Remember, we must have a common denominator if we add or subtract fractions. The least common denominator here is 6, which means we multiply the first by a 2 and the second by a 3, giving us 14/6 minus 27/6. Now we do the subtraction to give us negative 13/6, and we place this back inside the absolute value. And we bring everything else down. Now we have to finish the absolute value, remembering that it is still a parenthesis. Remember, an absolute value turns whatever's out inside of it into a positive number, meaning we get 13/6. Also, remember the parentheses. If you forget the parentheses, you may cause the problem to get a wrong answer. Remember, whenever you take something out of an absolute value, you put it into a parenthesis, especially if there is not an operation out front. Now, we are done with the P or parenthesis step, so we move on to the E or exponent step. We have 8/5 squared, which is 8/5 times 8/5, which gives us 64/25, and we place this below. And then we bring everything else down. Now, we are done with exponents, so we move on to the multiply and divide step. Remember, when two things are placed next to each other without an operation between them, it means that they are being multiplied, which means we have 9/10 times 13/6. We now must reduce this. 3 goes into 9 3 times, 3 goes into 6 2 times, and that is as far as this can reduce. So we now do 3 times 13 is 39, and 10 times 2 is 20. And we place this back in the problem. We now continue on with the problem. Remember, we must get an LCD when adding or subtracting fractions. The least common denominator between 25 and 20 is 100. This means that we multiply the 25 times 4 and the 20 times a 5. This will give us 256 over 100 minus 195 over 100. When we subtract, we get 61 over 100. This does not reduce, therefore it is our final answer.